name is Isha Sheikh and I am going to talk about the reputation. What is a reputation? How many types of reputation and how a person can buy a reputation in the court? Firstly, let's understand what is a reputation. Reputation is an order passed by High Court or the Supreme Court to lower court or courts to determine to detecting them to do something or stop from doing something. Writ is in form of written command in the name of the court. It directs a person to do a something in a specific way. In our Indian legal system, a person can file a reputation in the under Article 226 in the High Court and under Article 32 in the Supreme Court. Under Article 226 of Indian Constitution empowers the High Court to issue to any person or authority, including the government, directions, order, or writs, including the writs in nature of habeas corpus, mandamus, certiorari, prohibition, and quo warranto. Under Article 32, the Supreme Court has the power to issue directions or orders or writs in the nature of habeas corpus, mandamus, certiorari, quo warranto, prohibition, whichever may be appropriate for the enforcement of any right compared to the person. Under this article, a person can file a civil as well as a criminal writ petition if the cause of action of any case is in the nature of criminal law, just like rights of accused person and the bail, etc. So in that case, a person can file a criminal writ petition, and when the case is type of civil nature, just like taxes and the IPR. So in that case, a person can file a civil type of writ petition. Firstly, if a person files a writ petition in the High Court and after the order of the High Court, a person is not satisfied with the High Court's order, then that person moves to the Supreme Court. Next point is power to issue writ petition in the India is primarily provision to right to receive constitutional remedies to every citizen, and this right acts as guarantor of all other fundamental rights which are available in our country. Earlier, which I told you is about the what is a writ petition and how a person can file a writ petition. Moving forward, after this brief introduction, I must say you must have a lot of question about whether there is any specific type of writ petition for different criminal matters, different matters. So let me tell you guys, yes, there are mainly 5 types of writ petition which are available for different matters. That 5 types are as follows. First is the habeas corpus, second is mandamus, third is prohibition, fourth is quo warranto, and the fifth one is certiorari. First, let's understand what is the habeas corpus. The literal meaning of the word habeas corpus is you may have the body of. If a person can file a writ of habeas corpus when the person is illegally detained by a person. Let's understand with the example. If I am going to file a writ of habeas corpus in the court under Article 32 or 226, after that a person asks that person who is detained and examine him legally or illegally. After examining that person, the court decides whether that person is actually detained illegally or not. And if that person is detained illegally, then the court can order to release that person. A person can issue this type of writ petition under different circumstances. The circumstances are as follows. First is the person has been detained but not been produced before the magistrate within the 24 hours of arrest. Second one is arrest made without any violation of law by the person. Third is arrest has been made for unconstitutional law. And fourth one is detention made with the malafide intention. So if that 4 circumstances are going to be fulfilled, so in that case the person can file a writ of habeas corpus. Second one is writ of mandamus. Mandamus means weak command. A person can issue writ of mandamus when a public officer fails to perform his or her official duty or something which forms a part of his or her official duty. Writ of mandamus is matter of grace. date of mandamus is the matter of grace but not the matter of right. But there is a discretionary power with the court to approve that writ of mandamus or not. There are some requirements which court have to be decided for writ of mandamus. First requirement is that there should be a legal right in the existence. Second one is that the legal right should be enforceable by the court. Third one is enforcement of such right must impose the responsibility of person on a person, public authority, corporate or the government. Fourth one is such duty is of the public nature. So against whom the writ of mandamus can be applied in the court. So against that, the first one is am I individual person or a private body. Second one is if a duty which is the subject matter is discretionary but not the mandatory. Third one is against the president or the governor of any state. Fourth one is against the acting the chief minister. And fifth one is to enforce the private contract. Who can file the writ of mandamus? So any person, individual or private person can file a writ of mandamus in the law, in the court. So third writ is the writ of prohibition. As the name suggests, this writ petition issued to prohibit when the law court, including the tribunals, forums or any public authority acts which exceed their jurisdiction and Supreme Court or High Court prohibits them by issuing the writ of prohibition. This writ issued is stop or put the stay on the power exercised by the authority, that is called as the stay order. We must know, we all know that word. Conditions under which one can issue the writ of prohibition. First condition is when there is an excess of jurisdiction, and the second one is when there is an absence of jurisdiction. If these two conditions are going to be fulfilled, so in that case a person can file a writ of prohibition in the court. Fourth is writ of certiorari. Certiorari means to certified. A person can issue the writ of certiorari by the apex court or the transfer of matter it or any superiority. If the person feels that there has been no jurisdiction with the court or is not acting his duty officially properly, then the person can file a writ of certiorari and can transfer his case to the higher court. When subordinate state or quasi-judicial bodies acts in the absence of jurisdiction, excess of the jurisdiction and fails to make the use of the jurisdiction, so in that case a person can file a writ of certiorari. Fifth one is quo warranto, means by what authority or on whose authority is one holding the public office. Like say there is a writ that a person can be issued or restrain a person from acting in capacity of the public office to which he or she does have entitlement. When let us understand with the example, there is a vacancy available in the public office. To fill this vacancy, there is a 63 years old man hired to fill this vacancy. But if you know that in the government office, the retirement age is 60 years. So after 60 years, he is not allowed to do that personal thing. So in that case, any person can file a writ of quo warranto in the court. Essentials of this quo warranto writ is the first is post must be a public post. Second one is post held by a person without any legal authority. And the third one is office must be subordinated one and not the merely function or employment or settlement of the bill and duly.